Hey, what's up everyone? It's Chase, aka That Gay Jedi, and welcome to another video, or if you're new here, welcome to the channel. Happy Pride Month to everyone. I hope everyone's been having a wonderful Pride Month so far. And in case you didn't know, I am going to be switching my video schedule to every other Friday. I just want to let y'all know so I could balance everything in life and also spend more time curating my content and writing scripts and doing research and everything like that. We're in this for the long haul, besties. We got to adapt. Anyways, last week I shared a tweet asking everyone to send me who they think are the hottest Jedi or Sith. And because listen, Star Wars has a lot going for it, and one of those things is hot characters. So there were so many little hotties sent to me that I kind of broke the rules and I was like, you know what? Let's just break it into goodies and baddies. And maybe we can do more of these in the future because I already know people are going to be coming for me for not having Poe Dameron in this. But listen, I kind of wanted to have a balance of goodies versus baddies, and Poe would have tipped that scale. And anyway, now we can save him for another video.
What?
I ended up pulling 22 characters, most of which were from y'all's Twitter recommendations. And I am going to be tier ranking them with this handy dandy little tier list I made. And I'm going to be ranking them on personal, just me, personal subjective attractiveness that I feel towards these characters. Also, I wanted to give a quick shout out to my friends Justice, Cade, and Kevin for helping me with my tier names because it's been through a lot of iterations, but these are the tier names that we have. We have at the top, Hoth and Bothered, hashtag Hoth and Bothered. I think that speaks for itself. Some fire and ice. Feeling Hoth and Bothered, it's gonna be the top. Next we have Naboo Me Up Already, you know what I mean? They're sweet, they're so cute, we still have some attraction, but they're not exactly, you know, burning on Mustafar, it's sort of hot. Then we have Justin Dorable. This is kind of a nice neutral one where I'm not attracted to them, but I'm not necessarily outwardly attracted to them. And they're just adorable, they're so cute. In the fourth tier, we have, sorry, attachment is forbidden.
Attachment is forbidden.
And that's just a little nod where they're getting rejected and for the Jedi, attachment is forbidden. But I don't wanna fully dump them. But the last tier, I wanna fully dump them. So into the garbage chute, Slimo. I took a little liberty with that.
Into the garbage chute, Slimo.
So those are the tiers and let's dig in. And you might want to grab some water because it's about to get thirsty in here. All right, let's just start off with the one I hope we all agree on. Already Hoth and Bothered. The way Kit Fisto makes people feel, I just don't know if there's any other character that can do it the same way. It's just that smile, something about that smile in the animated, ma'am, in animated form. Oh, so obviously he will be going to Hoth and Bothered. Proudly displayed as the first character on my Hoth and Bothered list. Next, let's do, oh my God, heavy metal daddy. We love Darth Vader. Okay, I mean, I gotta be honest with you. I think I'm gonna put him in Hoth and Bothered. I swear it's not gonna be that. I swear I'm not doing that the whole time. Don't worry, I do have standards, and Darth Vader just happens to meet those standards on a physical level. I don't he's not very nice. Next up we have, oh, yeah. We have Trilla from Jedi Fallen Order. She's stunning. She genuinely is one of my favorite characters in Star Wars. I will say I don't necessarily have a particular proclivity to her, attractiveness wise, but we still stand. And in this home, that's enough to get married. So Trilla, Naboo Me Up Already. Okay, next up we have Dryden Voss. Listen, Paul Bettany, the way he makes me feel. He's not very nice though, and you know, that does have some say in my attractiveness towards people. I have to say, sorry, attachment is forbidden. For the main reason that Dryden Voss to me is just Darth Vader signals like daddy issues, but Dryden Voss signals like a toxic pattern of relationships, and I'd rather not be in that pattern, so I'm gonna politely decline. Ugh. Rey freaking Skywalker. Honestly, I just want her to beat me up in the best way. She's going straight to Hoth and Bothered. It's like not even a question for me. This she they. The way I want her to kick me in the face. Okay, next up we have Mr. Plo Koon. I will say emotionally attracted to him. I think he's like very sweet, grounded Jedi. Like good dad vibes. But I cannot lie. I'm here to be honest. He's gonna go to Justin Dorable because he is adorable. And like I said, he's like a good like dad vibe. I love him in Ahsoka's relationship. I can't freaking frame him the right way. So Justin Dorable. Like, not, I don't think I'd ever want to be booed up by him, but in his case, attachment isn't necessarily forbidden, so. Oh. Okay, now we're getting interesting. We have Mr. Snoke himself, and I mean, do I have to say anything? Like, I think we all know, into the garbage chute, Slimo. Not cute, and not nice. That is like, it's a double offense. I mean, that's the first one to be going into the garbage chute, Slimo. Just not my type, but peace and love, you know? I like want to whisper about it because he's so beautiful. He's so beautiful. And we're just going to put him right up here. Nothing bothered. Because Finn Dameron makes me feel some type of way. Okay, I have to say, already looking at my Hoth and Bothered list, I have some impeccable taste. Again, completely subjective, but I'm proud of how this is shaping up. All right, let's see who we got. Radio Disney, we're all here. Okay, Anakin Skywalker, I mean, come on. Kid born in 1995 over here, born and raised on the prequels, queer as folk, watching Star Wars. Anakin was the moment. And I've said it before and I'll say it again. Anakin Skywalker is just a sad boy. And as a off and on again sad boy since I was about 5 years old, I will say, we stand. Luminara. Oh, sorry, Luminara, that's on your face. Okay, that's on you. Okay. This is a Naboo me up, period. She is so, I don't really know what to say about her. I think we all know how much of a badass she is. And again, she falls into like that, I don't know if it's like Hoth and Bothered, but I would wife her up in a split second. I would wife her up if she was into it the way I want to raise a family with her. She would just be the best mom. Oh no, not you, Dooku. I'm honestly straight into the garbage chute, Slimo. He is so nasty. Like, he's just like not, I know like there's mean people and everything in Star Wars, but I don't know, something about his like attitude. Well, I will say something about his attitude is actually kind of attractive, but not for me because I have standards. Maybe. We'll find out by the end of this list, because Hoth and Bothered's getting pretty full pretty fast. This is so embarrassing. I should never have done this. Ugh, Marin, Jedi Fallen Order. Honestly, she is resilient. She is beautiful. She is grounded. She's freaking powerful, man. I Naboo me up. Not me. Okay. I honestly might end up swiping right on my Naboo me up already line. That is like, this is the, that's the team. That's the team to beat. Okay. Lady Tano. First of all, this is one of the most, the way, it's something about the costume in season 7. It's really is something about that costume. She looks phenomenal. We all know we love Ahsoka. I will say, there she is, right there. Okay, why am I even doing this? Why, I really don't know. Are these as obvious as I think they are? She's being Nabooed me up again. Raise a family, or let's just go on adventures together. Let's be that, you know, that couple that just gets married and travels. Lady Tano can do no wrong. Speaking of Lady Tano, Darth Maul. Listen, again, prequels, baby. Phantom Menace. Young, confused, queer kid. The everything about it. The tattoos. You know, they're not really tattoos, but, you know, the vibe. The vibe of the tattoos. He's a baddie. He's got those horns. He's got those eyes. Those bedroom eyes. Okay, Ayla Secura. I know a lot of people are, like, all about her, and I live for that, but, like, for me, it's a just adorable. Like, she's badass. I love her. I also love the voice actress of her in The Clone Wars. Like, she's fierce, but I think she's gonna be, like, a Plo Koon moment for me. You know, just adorable. Just, like, a little cute. Like so adorable. And, like, powerful. It's not, like, I say it like that, but it's not supposed to be, like, a demeaning, you know, adorable. But anyway, she's gotta be there. I don't know if I'd Naboo her up, but she's right there. Anyways, okay, next we have Aura Singh. Listen, she's fine. She's absolutely fine. I get the attraction there. I absolutely do. That high pony Ariana Grande could literally never. And the antenna, girl. But I will say, all of that said, she's not very nice. And I think I'm gonna have to hit her with a, you know, attachment is forbidden. I'm sorry, Aura Singh. And I'm sorry to all the Aura Singh stans out there. I love her. It's just, I can't get wrapped up in that. You know what I mean? Not again. Oh, Kanan Jarrus, Jedi Knight. I will say, every time, like, I forget about how much I am attracted to Kanan until I see him. And then I'm like, girl. Okay, it's also, like, not even fair, though, because he's voiced by Freddie Prinze Jr. And, like, growing up watching the live-action Scooby-Doo movies where he played Fred, I literally don't even have a choice but to be attracted to anything Freddie Prinze Jr. does. And then when it's a hot, awesome, wise, great dad Jedi, the attraction's gonna be there. And listen, I know not everyone loves his haircut, but when he cuts off his pony, it's a moment. Okay, honestly, plot twist. I am surprising even myself. I was gonna put him in Hoth and Bothered, but then I look at who's in Hoth and Bothered, and personally for me, he doesn't hit the same level, but I wanna marry him. Boo me up already, Kanan. I will be waiting on your call. Might be waiting a long time though. Okay, who do we have next? Oh, the Grand Inquisitor. Listen, Grand Inquisitor is, I get that he's hot. Like, I'm not attracted to him, but I'm also kind of not attracted to him. I'm sorry, I like him. I love him as a character. I love his costume. I love the markings. We love a yellow eye. We love the dark side, kind of. And for me, I would have to, again, hit him with the attachment is forbidden. Not garbage shoot, because he's still kind of hot. But, you know, he's not really my type. I'll say that. He's just not really my type. Hope's gonna kill me. Okay. But Asajj Ventress. Now we're talking. Asajj could, like, break my nose, and I would say thank you. I'm looking at the Hoth and Bothered tier again. I think I'm gonna have to say Naboo me up already. Not quite Hoth and Bothered, but, like, so close. Like, if I could, you know, just to keep the record clean, I'd put her right here. Just right there, halfway in between. But we're professionals and we play by the rules, so we're gonna put her in Naboo me up already. A fierce ass dom wife. Let's go, Asajj. You and me, baby. Hello there. Hello there indeed. I don't know, you know, I don't know many people who aren't attracted to Ewan McGregor. And I only know his stock is going to rise when the Kenobi show comes out. People are gonna be feeling some type of way. I know I will be. I'm already preemptively feeling that type of way. So obviously going straight to Hoth and Bothered. I think that's all I'm allowed to say about that on YouTube, at least. We love Obi-Wan. Ugh. Next up, we have everyone's favorite gay Jedi. Luke Skywalker in his Dagobah outfit, no less. I intentionally chose that outfit because that is the outfit that caused, you know, a little bit of double takes as a kid watching the movies. He looked good. Wait, also, can I clear this up with y'all? He has a Zac Efron vibe, right? I don't know if I've talked to, like, anyone about this at length, but, like, y'all gotta let me know. Him on Dagobah, like, training in Dagobah, like, is very High School Musical for me. But that's also because I was watching these around the same time. So clear that up for me in the comments. For me, he's got all of the Zac Efron vibes. He looks amazing. His arms are goals. And going straight to Hoth and Bothered. And last up. How could I not? How could I not? Not to mention, he was nominated a lot of times. And Kylo Ren, Ben Solo, doesn't matter any which way you can, any which way we can. Every time I see this photo, and every time we see this photo, baby. I don't know how appropriate was, how appropriate this costuming choice was for a Star Wars movie. I'm grateful for the costume choice though. Adam Driver, I think it's something about the sheer size of him. But then of course, Adam Driver is just charming. Ben Solo is adorable. And like, I think we all want, you know, someone like Ben Solo in our lives. And you know what? Sometimes we want someone a little Kylo Ren in our lives. So absolutely, let me look up here. Wait a minute. Absolutely gonna be in Hoth and Bothered. Not me filling up my Hoth and Bothered list. Okay. Okay, y'all, we gotta send me some less hot characters next time so that I can act appropriately. So, okay, I thought it'd be kind of fun to see where we are at with like the goodies and the baddies. It looks like a lot of the baddies did make it to the bottom tiers, so I am proud of myself, and that is what I mean by having standards, but also not surprised at all. You know I'm queer when I want to marry all these like badass freaking women who are just gonna kick my ass. I'm honestly very surprised by the just adorable team. I didn't think it would be just two of them, but it is just the two of them, and I stand by those choices. So you can drag me in the comments if you don't agree. But yeah, that's my list. This video was super fun to do. I know it's a little bit strange, but again, hot Star Wars characters are a part of Star Wars culture, therefore they are fair game in the YouTube world, and I think we need to normalize talking about hot Star Wars characters. Also, if you agree or disagree with any of these, I would love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. So please let me know where I stand with regards to your attractiveness towards these characters. And if you want me to do another one, let me know. Name another character you'd like to see in another one of these videos. Because again, it's silly, it's fun. I will be back in 2 weeks' time with something a little bit more serious. I'll be doing a top 10 queerest moments of Return of the Jedi, which I'm very excited for because it is one of the gayest movies of the original trilogy. It's probably the gayest movie in the entire saga. So that will be fun. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please consider subscribing and hitting the notification bell so that you get notified when I post new videos. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And yeah, thank you all so much for watching. It means the world. Have a wonderful rest of Pride Month, and gay the force be with you always.